ever wondered how these bridges and other superstructures are constructed on water? The simple question that comes to our mind is how they construct such huge structures inside water without the disturbance of the surrounding water in lakes, rivers, and even oceans. Some of the best engineering wonders of such superstructures on water would be the Royal Albert Bridge, which was completed in 1859, and the famous the Brooklyn Bridge, constructed in 1883. Let us try to understand how are these marvels made and how do they last for centuries. We start with the basic geotechnical survey. Geotechnical surveys assess the underwater soil and rock conditions. Boreholes are drilled and the soil sample is taken and tested for a detailed report. From this report, we get to know the soil consistency and structure and the groundwater level, which is helpful in determining the best foundation type and to identify if there could be any potential challenges during and after construction. Apart from geotechnical surveys, specifically for underwater construction, and the report is also needed, which is hydrographic surveys. This survey helps us to understand the underwater topography, where we could find the water depth, what kind of soft mud is present, and how deep the bedrock is. This report helps us to decide on what kind of design, materials, and structures could be used for a higher stability. Geotechnical survey and hydrographic survey helps us to decide on where to build and how to build these superstructures. Bedrock is a rock surface beneath the water level. Constructing over a bedrock gives us a strong foundation. These underwater constructions are made on bedrocks and sometimes on hard mud. Now it's time to get the site ready for construction. Some of the initial preparation work would be removing the debris, vegetation, and obstacles to create a clear area for construction. Now it's time to start laying the foundation. We need to excavate the area and dig to create a stable foundation. But the major obstacle is water. If we dig inside water, the surrounding water would fill up the dug-up area. In order to overcome this obstacle, various construction methods are used. First and the most extensively used method would be caissons. They act as a foundation for the piers of the bridge. Piers are nothing but the giant upright support for an arch or a bridge. Caissons are prefabricated watertight structures floated to the construction site and are sunk into the water, extending above the water level. There are various types of caissons, like box caisson, which is open at the top and closed at the bottom. These are first anchored to the bedrock and then the concrete is being filled up. Open caisson is just like box caisson but open at both ends. These are the majorly used types, but there are other types of caissons as well, such as monolithic caisson, pneumatic caisson, excavated caissons, etc. In some cases, instead of caissons, cofferdams are used. Cofferdams are similar water retaining structures, but cofferdams are removed after the construction is completed. Cofferdams are temporary structures, whereas caissons are not removed and stay as the integral part of the pier's foundation. Once the caissons are placed on the construction site, dewatering is done, where the water inside the caisson is pumped out to create a dry working space. After dewatering, A series of wells are made inside the construction site into the bedrock, and the water from the ground is also pumped up. This is to keep the groundwater level to a much lower level. Now the caisson is filled up with steel and concrete deep into the riverbed through the drills for a stronger foundation. Once the concrete is filled up, the foundation is ready for the pier construction. Since these are underwater construction, skilled divers perform tasks such as cutting, welding, etc. Robotic devices are used for tasks that are too deep or dangerous for human divers. Materials like stainless steel and special coatings are used to protect structures from corrosion. Also, special additives like silica fume and fly ash are used to enhance the durability of underwater concrete. So once after these underwater structures are completed, the bridges are constructed. Underwater construction requires careful planning, specialized techniques, and equipment to ensure the stability and safety of structures built below the water surface.